trash. Oops, I just attacked the trash. You gotta be sure. You never know when there's gonna be a freaking garbador. Or whatever the hell. This is a two-way zipline. No, you just walk right through. There's some stuff that a PS2 or a PS1 game would not have done. Like some items just, you know, the collision was basic, but there still would have been collision for that. I guess that's our spooky tower. And the warping's a little exaggerated. Some more missing collision. Hold it right there. I shuddered as I heard a voice call out from behind. Although I couldn't see him, it was a male voice. He'd probably been watching the entire time. You got the documents? The man's voice was cold. I held up the documents GP gave me. Alright, looks good. Those voices weren't different enough. Whatever. I've been meaning to, like, practice voices and, like, create a few unique voices and, like, I need to name them. That's, like, thing one is to define a voice and name it so you can think, like, okay, this guy is, you know, Joe. But, like I said, I was trying to say earlier, years ago, I actually tried to plan that out and didn't end up doing it. There's actually a game I intended to practice voices on. There's an RPG Maker game that was, like, actually, like, real-time battle and, like, you're, like, some sort of SRPG sort of looking thing. It looked pretty cool, and I ended up not doing it. It's quite a few things I ended up not doing, to be quite honest. I'm trying to, you know, keep my pace up better this year. And, well, through all of last year, really. It's locked by the other side. What the hell is this thing? I'm not sure this is what you're supposed to have on top of your roof. It's a freaking Large Hadron Collider over here. I'm trying to just, you know, uninhibit myself and just play games. Like, I didn't practice this one before or anything. I just decided to, you know, just get to it and do it, and I need to do that with more games. Okay, this angle's confusing me, which is, like, you know, the quintessential PS1 angle. Just confuse. Oh. Just a little confusing. Alright. Huh? I figured for sure that was the way. Oh, it's a ladder.
Can I go up?
Who puts their trash on top of the air conditioning things? And there's tables on the air conditioning fans. Come on, guys. Oh, hello. Kent. Hey there. I don't think that computer, like, how would you have a wire up here? Whatever. I greeted the first person that I saw. Was this guy watching me through the gate? The thin, long-haired man glanced up at me and laughed feebly. Nice to meet a new face around here. His face was different from the one I'd heard earlier. He said his name was Harris Bailey. Wait, I thought it was Kent. Is Kent me? I don't know who I am. I'm sorry. I quickly asked him how to get to the tower. He said that you could zipline there from the building next door. However, it wasn't that simple. See, I'm also looking for a way out of here. The ladder leading there is blocked by a fence. If you want to reach the tower, you have to find a way through. Here's handing me a key. Ah! Oh. Okay. How would you get a power cord to this thing? I guess I'm Kent. This is news to me. Having an identity crisis. Oh, it's a save PC! Okay, so there's a gameplay reason for it to be here. Silly as it is. I've been chugging cough medicine and taking cough drops, so you can't blame me for the cough. Done all I can. It's one annoying thing about a job that requires your voice. You're kind of screwed if you're sick. I mean, I don't program too great when I'm sick either, but I don't really need to talk. Well, it depends what I'm doing, but, you know, requirements gathering crap usually requires vocal communication with some sort of meat person, but, assortment of door parts, and lockers are wrapped with sturdy-looking wire. Just assorted geometry smashed in there. It's a kitty! Is this... We've got three kinds of door. Oh, wait. This is just a thing. Elevator. It's a tiny-ass elevator. So, I've been meaning to swear less. Well, I guess this is an M-rated game anyway. Or is it even? I guess maybe this is T? I don't know. It's a horror game. Horror games are usually M. But, I mean, visuals are pretty tame. But, yeah, anyway. I'm not anti-swearing myself, and I'll never be a totally safe-for-work channel. But, somebody actually commented the other day on Twitter that they were glad they could watch my videos with their daughter. And I try not to swear just for swearing's sake. Aw, not another one of these. I don't swear a ton in person. Is this even more... I seriously do not need all of these painkillers. How many... I have 11 painkillers. I'm just going to pop a bottle right now. Yeah, status 100%. I don't even... Ah! Seriously, escape should exit that menu. Ugh, my mind's going everywhere. Anyway, I don't swear a ton, and I mean, I think I could pretty much eliminate it entirely. Oh, shotgun shells! If I put a little effort into it and just... Or, I could just mark videos that I do swear in, like rage quit platformers and stuff. I tend to avoid those anyway. But some videos I'm gonna swear in, and I could just, you know, give a little content warning at the start. I've been trying to do that just in general. Oh! There was... How was I supposed to... I don't think a PS1 game would have made it that unobvious that there was a walkway here. Yeah, the cameras were bad, but they weren't deliberately bad, you know. 2001? You're 2000... What? I thought this was 1995. Bro. Why did the camera stick? Whatever. Yeah, I'm not a prude about swearing or anything, but on the other hand, I don't think it's particularly necessary for the most part, and I never wanted to be, like, I deliberately tried to not be. Oh, it's just a key here. I was expecting it to tell me about the bust. I'm all about them busts. I don't want to be like the Angry Gamer channel, where Angry Gamer Dude says every game is crap, and feces, and poop, and all of those things. And every game they ever played was terrible, etc. I just wanted to show cool games. Sometimes they're not great. Sometimes they're good and bad. But I just want to show a good variety of games, and I want people to enjoy new things. And it helps a little bit if it's, you know, it helps a little accessibility-wise if there's no swearing or offensive stuff. I definitely try to not be offensive. Oh, crap. Okay. We're gonna take some damage here. Would you die? Okay. We finally have an excuse to use some of those painkillers. Maybe I shouldn't have wasted them after all. They're not as effective as I thought, so I guess maybe it's alright that we have a bunch. Whatever. We're gonna be fine. A note! A note. Why doesn't it just go to the note screen, honestly? To Biff! Before you go home tonight, make sure you give the cleaners the instructions for the building management system. They're in the suitcase I showed you the other day. You remember, right? The passcode is in the last three digits of our food sanitation number. I know you don't have the greatest memory, so hopefully that'll help. Ha! Okay, I have to take a screenshot here. It's Biff. That's a good name. Biff. I really hope me clicking out of the window isn't screwing up the recording. I'm a little paranoid. I didn't think I would have to... Oh, hello, friend. Excuse me! That is such a weak taking damage sound, and there's no animation. It's just... They stagger, but I don't. That is not horror game mechanics. Oh. What is the red thing? I wanted to know what the red thing was. Alright, so we have more puzzles. I'll probably have to go off screen to figure out the puzzles, because I... I'm doing all of this talking, and it really reduces my ability to puzzle. Have I been everywhere I can be? I don't think so. I think I'm still missing bits of this puzzle. Oh. I've been here. Also, the load times when opening, or like the black screen when bringing up a message seems pretty unnecessary. Oh, we got lunch. Let's get some lunch. Excuse me. See, it's just so non-threatening. Like, it's not a problem that I don't have to take damage from every enemy, but it's just so easy to do so. Like, I just at least have to do some ducking and weaving here. See, that menu I can exit from with the escape button. What's this? I can see that. What's it say? Certificate of Excellence. Food sanitation. Here's our food sanitation number. Everyone, please remember the last three digits of your food sanitation number. Wait, hang on. What was the... Biff. Okay, the passcode... Okay, certification code. So it's simple this time. There's no subtracting. Oh! I could have missed that shotgun if that camera angle hadn't transitioned just right. Okay, we got the shoddy. Go ahead, make my day. Stupid. Oh! You are gonna make my day! Okay! I was threatening the microwave, but I should have been threatening you. Okay. Oh, frickin', why don't you load these things? It's got udders! It's got udders! It is not even aggressive. It wasn't until I shot it. It was passive. I didn't... Come on. Even as an easy mode boss, that would have been a little disappointing. Did I just waste a shot? Oh wow, I have 28 shotgun shells, and 4 of them killed the boss. Well, I think that was a boss. That was a boss. There's no way that was a normal thing. But I mean, the difficulty should kind of be... Oh man, where was the... I know there was a thing. I just don't know where it was anymore. So I'm not... Do these respawn? I just spit on my mic a little. Oh, there is a carrot at the top. It's just hard to see. 9. I do like that it just immediately unlocks, because that makes it a lot easier to spam things on accident. For the building superintendent, cleaning of the building's outer walls will go on as planned. Work is to begin tomorrow morning. Enter with the top floor. Please tell the boss that the window scaffolding is up and ready to go. I'd probably use the scaffold. I should tell Harris this. You needed a passcode to open a briefcase to realize that you could use the scaffolding. You didn't look. Whatever. Look how casually he carries that shotgun. Just like it's just weighs nothing. I really want to shoot one of these with a shotgun to see what happens, but it's probably boring. Oh, this is the cafeteria again. Wait, what's this? I didn't fully explore the cafeteria. I got distracted. And also, sorry about derping around the puzzles. I have to constantly talk for, you know, the whole Let's Play situation, and it does inhibit my ability to remember and think about puzzles. Sorry. I should really be sucking on a cough drop right now. Atomic collider explodes. Terrorism is suspected. Reports indicate that the Atom Collider at the UK 1K Foundation exploded today at dawn. Police are currently investigating as an accident, although foul play is presumed. Furthermore, the whereabouts of Dr. Randall, frequent user of the collider, are currently unknown, and she is wanted for questioning. We've also confirmed no leakage of contamination as a result of the incident. So is that where we got our third dimension? Some frickin' terrorists blew up a thing. Oh! That's good. These conspicuous support pillars. You know what? Screw it. Boom! Aw. I knew it would be disappointing. I just had to confirm it. I definitely think some AI and difficulty tweaks would improve this quite a bit. I guess I'm just going back, aren't I? I need to go tell that dude, hey, use the scaffolding you should have seen like a billion years ago. Jerk. Oh, that's not what I meant to do. Also, I was expecting it to be more silly than it was. Wait, I'm going in circles. But Dino Crisis 1 is a very good survival horror-y thing. It does get, you know, a little pants on head at the end of the game. But that only it only gets silly by the second game itself. You know, gameplay-wise, it's a pretty solid survival horror-y deal. So if you played Silent Hill and never played Dino Crisis, definitely give Dino Crisis a shot. I should stream a bunch of old school survival horror stuff sometime. I need an actual PS1 at some point though. I think I can record a PS1 through my it'll only be 30 frames per second, but I can do it through my old school thinger. I showed them the note. My old capture card, I mean. I showed him the note downstairs. Not Harris nodded while reading it. The window scaffolding, huh? Not bad. If I got on the scaffolding hanging outside the building, I should be able to get... How did you not notice this? It's pretty dangerous two floors below here, so make sure you're Eddie. I'll make sure I'm Eddie, pal. I'll make sure. I don't remember scan lines being nearly this intense. I need to get myself a CRT. It's hard to get a CRT, you know that? I think you need to shop like Goodwill and crap. excuse me. I just really hate going to stores. Well, I'm pretty shy, which is weird for somebody that, you know, has a hobby where I talk to strangers all day. But I'm pretty shy. I do not like going to new places. I don't like driving to new places. I don't like finding new stores, so having to shop around is a not... PS1 does not warp anything like that. So where am I looking? Where's the scaffolding crap? Just gonna clip through that. Clip through this. What is this? Oh, is that our zipline? I am looking for the scaffolding, right? I was so busy talking about the scaffolding that I forgot to read. Oh! It's what this thing is made for. Staircase after the chained up. Now I need to get through. Oh, we need to go through the thing, the barricade, I guess. Sorry, but my talking all the time is ruining my reading comprehension, I guess. It's actually kind of hard to read something and fully comprehend it. Like, that sounds stupid, but I'm entirely capable of reading something aloud and not actually like properly comprehending it. It's a skill. I keep expecting spacebar. Like, I'm not used to both hands being on the keyboard. That I haven't done this in years. Like, old school PC games would make you do that, but usually I'm thinking of the mouse. You summoned all your strength. You summon, like, my brain goes different places when you say summon like that. I was like, you summon Odin to take apart the barrier. I kind of wasn't expecting that to work, but whatever. Can't use the staircase. It's just a black void. Can't use the black void staircase. Oh! This is also a black void. This is the black void floor. Not related to the Pink Floyd floor. What? I guess these are like security access things? They're not security, like maintenance. Oh! It was a normal enemy! You need a little help there, buddy! Okay, so it wasn't a boss. Did I accidentally fire there? How many shotguns? I should probably heal. Ugh, that's so awkward. Can I load my thing? Zero? Oh, that's current shots, isn't it? How many shells does it hold? Eight? That doesn't look like an eight-shot shotgun. Whatever. Oh. You can pleasantly just walk over that. Empty whiteboard? I was gonna say a thing before those monsters showed up. I completely forget what it was. Torn out piece of paper. Let's read it. Oh, right. I should probably check how long this video is. I'm probably gonna need to chop this up into a couple videos. Whatever. Everyone here is out of their minds. I thought everything had fallen into place. Boy, was I wrong. It's chaos here. Everyone is turned against each other. No word for the outside world. Why don't you just make it loop? It's such a nice touch that spooky music plays when you start reading the spooky notes. But then it just goes back to normal old music. And that was definitely not enough time to read this. It's only a matter of time before things get ugly. I need to get out. Come to think of it, I heard if someone else was planning on escaping. I should probably stick with him. Oh. I should probably accidentally pull my gun on myself. Trust no one. Not even yourself. The game's so easy, I don't really care about losing that shotgun shell. It was worth it. Okay, once I get to the next save point, I'll save, and I'll figure out where I need to chop the video, and I'll also get myself a cop drop. Because this is a problem. Wait, what's this? The scaffolding switch? There's a scaffolding switch? I don't think that's how scaffolding works. I could be wrong. Wait, no. Can I go back down? I don't think I was done exploring. Was I? I turned the scaffolding on. Is that a thing you can do? Let's go get Harris, I guess. Harris, old buddy. It's going down. I turned the scaffolding on. We're good to go, I guess. Is that all the crap I summoned my strength to move? Summon the power of Odin? I'm just gonna say that if this dude could push it over, I'm pretty sure those giant monsters. Where did you go, Harris? Harris, you piece of crap. How dare you? Alright. I'm gonna see how to split these videos. I may just continue immediately. I may cut this off as the end of a video. I'm not sure. That's why I need to pay more attention to my video times. But yeah, sorry about all the coughing. I actually am sick, so there's not that much I can do about it. Yeah, I've been trying to keep to three videos a week. I haven't broken that yet, except for one video I ended up deleting, my Polyrace video. The frame rate was crap, and the source video just, like, the game's frame rate is fine normally, but the recording was just crap. Yeah, there's definitely some wonky... I think this game could be improved without, you know, total rewrite, but there's some stuff that's a little, I think the game could definitely be improved without, you know, huge old budget. Yeah, when I return, we will climb this ladder, so stay tuned. Or maybe I'll climb this ladder immediately. I don't know. That's why I need to watch my times. Sorry, I messed up a recording, but you missed literally nothing but me climbing the ladder. There wasn't even an animation. So I got myself cough drop, drank some awful cough medicine. That's something I would really pay a premium for it to not taste like garbage, but it always does. Ooh, got some new graphics. It's a nice looking penthouse. Look at that. I would live here. I would live in this low resolution heck hole. I remember everything up until I passed out. I was doing a voice for this guy. When I rode the zip line, I remember a voice calling out to me. It was a woman's voice, one I recognized, albeit vaguely. Then there I was, standing in an unknown place. Silence was deafening, and the pomp of the room gave off a ghastly vibe. Pretty nice place. Yeah, this warping is quite a bit exaggerated. I did want to say, I was a little sad that Degisa Games, they used to go through VG Smart PR, which is a one-man operation, Joe Lieberman. He covered a lot of games. He was, like, I guess the very first indie PR company, or, like, you know, organization, whatever, you know, PR dude. And he just quit the business this year. It isn't time to go there. It's a little forced. I can go up here, though. Well, whatever. Oh, people. But yeah, I just wanted to say that VG Smart, for Pete's sake, VG Smart was my favorite, you know, PR thing. You know, it was my favorite. Every time Joe emailed me, it was something cool. And it's going to suck to not get his emails anymore. I never thought I'd feel that way about, you know, a PR company, but, here I am. I don't know if Joe watches my videos, but if you do, you are appreciated. You will be missed. Why can't I get in? Why can't I get... Oh. Okay. That was a little awkward. Oop. I'm not going to waste any more bullets, as funny as it is. Are you kidding me? I can't go around that thing. I wasn't coughing this much when I started, so I think I'm doing some damage here, but I don't like to get out of practice, so. Before I could get another word out, the older woman spoke in a gentle yet stern voice. My name is Elfrida. I'm in charge here. She followed that up by stating that she didn't care who I was. It's a little hard to read here. As long as you're here, there are rules you need to follow. Look at that face! Oh my god, it's terrifying. I need to go to that tower, I answered. I pointed out the window in the direction of the tower, but it is nowhere to be seen. Was another building in the way? Elfrida spoke again. Now, no need to be in such a rush. They'll come for you. So you just wait here like a deer. You want me to wait? That's right, just sit tight. Don't you animate at me. I don't need your animations. I'm out of here with that crap. You can just sit here with your animations, and I'll walk slightly to the right. That's right, I can walk slightly to the right now. I don't need your bullcrap. This is another one of those awkward things that I don't really think a PlayStation 1 game would have done. Got a spherical. We can't walk on the tiger skin rug. It's too posh. We're just like, nah, I can't walk on that. That's above my pay grade. Oh, this texture immediately reminded me of a very dramatic moment in, what was it? Was it Calm? The big clamshell place in, Legend of Legaia. Great game. That might be a little nostalgia talking, but I actually think it was my first RPG on the PlayStation 1, and I love the heck out of it, and there's a very dramatic part I was just reminded of. What? Strange opening at the front of the desk. Like a drawer could be pulled out. This is definitely a thing that we need spooky music for. There's a spooky drawer that I apparently refuse to open. Why? Look at the thing on the desk, bro! There's a thing on the desk! There's a spooky drawer that I can't open, apparently. Not sure what that's all about. You can't go past that. This plant's blocking the way there. That makes sense. That's fine. Okay. So I can go this way too now. It's a nice pool. The warping's a little too artificial for me. Huh? Apparently that's a wall? You're not even going to say anything about the pool. Ugh. I was kind of wondering what stuff I could do to create like a PS1 sort of effect. I guess maybe the warping polygons are harder than I think. Let me look at that. It's like they're kind of like the textures being rotated on some sort of weird axis. It's not really... Like, what's up with the PS1 is that it doesn't have a Z buffer, so it doesn't really know certain things about depth. Excuse me? There was nothing? Can I go up? Granny? Did I wait long enough? I'm missing something. There was a thing. Granny, can I open that drawer? I obviously need precision. No, I can't! Admire my plants. Okay. No, I can't. Ugh, Parky. Hi. Admire my plants. Parker, get down. Get down. I can hear his whispering. I love when he whispers. Parky, you gotta get down. I can't walk past this chair. I'm defeated by the chair. Alright. Why won't you open the stupid drawer? You see, there is a ladder. Or not a ladder, stairs. I get those two confused. Okay, so there's obviously something in this room that's very important. Like a refrigerator with a painting on it. Oh, a crank! Oh, it's for the... We needed a crank, maybe? A newspaper clipping. Creature found on campus. Police investigate. A month has passed since the Atom Collider explosion. Locals are demanding authorities investigate reports of mutated creature spotted near the site of explosion. However, the police maintain that there have been no such creatures. Due to the high likelihood of a mass hysteria outbreak, they vowed to continue the investigation. The fourth dimensional wall. Pfft. See, there's some bad stuff going on with this whole dimension business. Everything was better back when everything was 2D. That's what I say. We never had these survival horror games. Mm-hmm. They actually did, though. The first survival horror game that I'm aware of, anyway, is actually Sweet Home from the NES. Though it's an RPG. Use the crank, please. Why don't you just frickin' pull on it? Why is this a thing that requires spooky music, and you refuse to just pull on it? I don't understand you, Kent. Is the crank the lock, the thing that I need for this? It probably isn't. Why am I so baffled by this hallway? Granny, I found your crank. Will you let me go now? Am I a good enough boy? Really wish I could skip faster. It hasn't been an issue because I love that I have the same move speed forward and back. That's something that, like, no survival horror game would ever do. It looks kind of silly. I wouldn't generally mind, but I mean, you're not supposed to be able to back up and, like, hit an enemy back up. That's supposed to be a difficult sort of thing. This game's combat, it's not difficult. Oh! Oh! There's yet another room I didn't see. Gigantic TV. Like, truly gigantic. It's good old-fashioned 40-inch CRTs that weigh... Like, how much would that weigh? Like, a CRT, a tenth the size of that, is like 20 pounds. I would not volunteer to move it, that's all I gotta say. Is it? What do I need a crank for? Tiger skin rug, tell me. Tell me what I need this crank for. This is the most boring way to be lost. I have a crank. Does anybody need some cranking? Oh, my head disappeared. I got this nice pool. Why don't you just go in the pool? Relax. Have some fun, you know? This is exactly the time for some pooling around, if you know what I mean. I wonder if examine the plants is like a hint that there's something hidden in a plant. Which would be stupid, but possibly, yes, the thing to do. I don't know. He doesn't even want to get close to that plant. He's like, nah, that plant, it's a jerk. That plant doesn't have anything in it. I just want to leave, old lady. I'd shoot her, but it wouldn't work. Why do I have a crank? What does the crank do? Why would I have a crank? I haven't seen anything to crank. I'm just gonna say crank until the end of this video. That's the entire video. Sir Tap Tap versus Cranks. The Cranks win. Crank Man, Crank Man. Please don't invent Crank Man. Okay. There's. I guess I'm just gonna wander around until I find a thing. I don't know. I don't know what to tell you. You used the crank from the menu, which was never a thing until now. Oh, I'm so mad. Well, I'm not that mad, but still. That's dumb. And that's the thing a PS1 game would make you do, but it's still dumb. It should have used the thing for you. Ugh. Whatever. Dear Papa, if you're reading this, everything is just as I predicted. The stupid human used the crank. Believe me, he didn't realize it. He didn't realize he'd have to open the item menu to use it. Believe me, I want you to tell you everything in person, but this is the only way I can reach you. I forgive you for everything you've done, so please forgive me what I'm about to do. I'm about to make a puzzle where you have to use the frickin' item menu. Alyssa, wait, is that someone I know? Nope. Spook? There's a note on the floor. That was not the floor. That was definitely the desk. That was definitely on the desk. Excuse me, I'm trying to read. Patient should be hospitalized. It is not safe for him to be home in this state. When he saw the paperwork, he sent his wife. He flew into a rage and ripped it to shreds. Mr. Kent Randall. Wait. I'm Kent Randall? It's the dude. It's the doctor's my wife. Okay. He's in denial of the current state, convinced of the year 1995 when he's still in good health. He seems to have disavowed himself. Okay, things are getting good here. Becoming unable to function in society. Okay. I shouldn't have aimed. I think there's a monster. Because I just aimed towards a thing. Oh! Spooky legs! I'm sorry, how do I take a... I wanted to take a screenshot, sorry. I wish I hadn't spoiled that there's monsters. I just wanted to make sure my gun was ready. There's a note on the floor. Excuse me. Mr. Kent Randall. The patient collapsed in his home again. He was brought in by his family and should be hospitalized as soon as possible. According to tests, Mr. Randall seemed to suffer some severe encephalopathy. His cognitive abilities may be gradually deteriorating. Maybe he can't run anymore. I guess that's why survival horror people can't run. Severe encephalopathy or whatever. Look at the seats. Oh, there's multiple dudes. Whoa, per. That actually kind of startled. Whoa! Barker. Now is not the time for your crap. Okay. I guess if there's just going to be a ton of monsters around, maybe it's okay that they're kind of weak. Barker, get down, please. Wait, was that my wife? No, that wasn't my wife. This is not my beautiful wife. There's a note on the floor. This is not my beautiful house. Sorry, I just had to yell a reference at my cat. I heard some patients trying to escape again. That's the third time this month. What the hell is security doing? What is security? Why is there a cat here? Security. One of them tried to jump off the roof. It took them the week to find the other one. This continues to damage my spread to the outside. Management might need to rethink how they run this place. So there's some sort of, like, home for people like me that got screwed up in the head or something. I gotta read all the documents. So. Ah, freaking cat. I really don't need itchy cat hair all over me right while I'm having. I wonder if it's just allergies, actually. I'm not sure if I'm sick or not. My coworker has been sick, but he's like constantly sick, so I mean. It's hard to say if I got something from him. I'm always sick on weekends. It sucks. So, not on the floor. April 8, 1995. The correct current year. I was a little suspicious of that 2013, but yeah, it is. Oh, I forgot to mention, this game, $12. It is, for the first week or so, it is, $9.59, oddly. But yeah, it's a 20% discount, so that's why. But yeah, ever since Kent collapsed a few months ago, I thought he'd been acting strange. Today's behavior confirmed my suspicions. For some reason, he decided to hide the key to his room. Didn't explain why. It's quite the mess. What? Why is quite the mess? Oh! We found the key, but maybe it needs to be your guys. How was that quite the mess? Like, I was expecting to hear that, like, after I'd eaten somebody's face off or something. Creature found on campus. Police investigate. A month has passed. Since the Atom Collider explosion, locals are demanding authorities investigate reports of the mutated creatures spotted near the outside of the explosion. However, the police have been. So I guess it has been in 1995, which. Somebody should still have a camera, excuse me. Parker? I'm more scared of my cat than I am of these monsters, because. I know there are hostile things, and then I hear noises in real life. And that unsettles me, not the actual monsters. The leg thing is a good monster, I will admit. Sit down on the floor. Like, I'm gonna be in a VR horror game, and Parker's gonna bump my leg, and I'm gonna, like, freak out and fall on my ass or something. Like, Parker is going to be the most horrifying thing in VR horror games. Anyway, they brought a new patient in, male, in his 40s. Severe brain issues and violent tendencies. Apparently his mind is stuck in 1995, so we're not supposed to show him anything that came after that year. Since cognitive ability stuck in 1995, anything came afterwards appeared completely foreign to him. Up! Oh! Looks like it's time to move on. That's not meta at all. Hi, lady. Up! Hi. I actually have a girlfriend, so I'm just gonna have to get out of here and, yeah. I'd really like to party with you. Look at all these monsters. I kind of like that there's just a bunch of monsters chilling around. And I'm just gonna walk away from all of that. I don't need to deal with that. Parker? What are you doing? I'm trying to embrace the spooky, Parker. Chill out. New word for the day. I hear someone's voice in the distance. My senses, Parker! What are you doing? What do you have? What do you have? What is that? Hold on. Whenever he's having too much fun with something, it's never a toy. It's always something that he shouldn't be having. What do you have? What are you playing with? Oh. You got one of my cough drops. Okay, sorry about that. My senses are fading, but I can faintly hear a voice calling out for me. How many years has it actually been? I don't even know anymore. I can't keep torturing Alyssa like this. I beg of you, please set me free. What? Don't kill yourself, bro. Guess I have to. Whee! Splat. Game over. Throw the warp code out. Oh, is the game actually over?
Parker?
Developed by Takaki Ichijo. I guess the game's literally over. Huh, pretty short. Is that a couple hours? Maybe less, I don't know. I split into so many videos, I have no concept anymore. It's over, go home! That's ominous. We didn't reach the tower. Wait, the tower was the thing he wanted to jump off. Okay, I get it. So that's back in 99. 95, I keep wanting to call it 90. Yep, just loops back over. Been trying to move on. Only there can I finish this. It is neat that it's one of those things where the beginning makes more sense once you go through. Once you're actually beaten it. But yeah. A little simpler than I was expecting. Not bad, but doesn't really capture that more genuine fright that Silent Hill itself did. Not really because of the shortness, but just the combination of the music, the monsters. And it could be a little more authentic in regards to the, particularly the warping textures, and just some more polish would have helped too. But yeah, that was back in 99. I do want to see more PlayStation 1 throwbacks. I do think there's a lot of potential there. I don't really like 8-bit throwbacks for the most part. I don't think 8-bit is a particularly great look. 16-bit, yes. 32-bit 3D, kinda, yeah. But I guess we will end it there. That is back in 1995, as I have said for the third time.